Grace, mercy, and peace are yours from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The text I wish to spend some time on today is from the second chapter of Galatians, our epistle lesson, where we read as follows. Paul says, verse 20, I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. This is our text. I don't know about you, but whenever I look at a baby, such as little Pippa, I am drawn to the whole life they have before them. I think about the fact that they don't have yet any regrets, any scars, any broken dreams, broken friendships, bad memories, sad losses, or painful experiences. It's like looking at a pure field of new snow. You know that eventually it's going to be filled with history, ruts and tracks, and the changes that come with time and age. It's inescapable. Yet it's pure and beautiful from the outset. No dirt, no tread marks, tromp marks, divots, or damage. Just a simple blanket of beauty. Pippa, her whole life ahead of her, a virtual field of white snow. And then in contrast, you look in the mirror and you consider your own existence. And there's a whole score of things that run through your mind. From the nicks and scrapes that come from daily living, a broken finger, a scar, surgical repair, clinical removal, lens correction, and the scars of life too. Mistreatment from a friend, bad choices, lies, shattered dreams, moments you wish you could rewrite, or forget, or snip out of your life like a filmmaker who leaves the bad takes on the cutting room floor. But they're part of you, and you can't edit them. Hard as you might try, you just can't rewrite the script. I remember, for instance, the eighth grade bully who took out his aggressions on me. I think back on the things I could have said, the different choices I could have made so that he didn't steal from me some of the good memories that I could have had. I relive it in my head. But in the end, it's not going to change. Or I remember that my mother wanted me to learn how to play the piano. And I agreed for a few months to learning some things about chords and fingering and the like. But my busy school schedule and some personal fun things that I had to do instead halted me from practicing. And in fairly short order, I gave it up. I regret that. And I know what you're saying. Oh, you still can do it. I know that. But it's not the same as learning in youth. The moment has passed, the time is late. The desire and the potential is not what it was. And now, almost 56 years later, the marks are everywhere. Some more painful than others. The death of my parents, being in a horrific car accident, sins I've committed, and sins that have been committed against me by others. But for the most part, I gotta say, life has been really good. But for some, the scars are much more difficult. War veterans who saw and were a part of horrific things. Victims of abuse, physical, sexual, verbal. Those who grew up in alcoholic homes, homes with domestic violence. Those who lost loved ones at an early age, who suffered with severe disabilities, victims of crimes, as we heard of even again this morning, tragic accidents and the like. Their memories are tarnished with scenes so painful that they may affect them every single day. Looking at them on the outside, you may not know. You might just look like every other person. Let's face it, my friends. There's a lot of pain out there. And probably there's a lot of pain in here, too. A lot. Too much. And all of us, whether for greater or for least, have experienced it at some level. What do you bring to the table today? What package, what piece of baggage would you like to leave on the cutting room floor? What things have happened to you, been done to you, been said about you, that churn in here again and again and play games with your mind? Kippa, or any baby for that matter, makes us think of life and how history molds and shapes you to be who you are. It's filled with joys and pleasures, no doubt. Also filled with some pains and sorrows. We hope and pray for Pippa that her life will be overwhelmingly filled with beautiful and wonderful. But we also know, realistically, that life has many curveballs, twists, and turns. But today, brothers and sisters in Christ, Pippa teaches us something else, if we listen carefully to the words of our lessons for today. Did you notice the words of our text? Paul writes, I read again, I have been crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. In the life that I now live, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Paul declares the truth that being connected to Christ regularly gives us a fresh new start spiritually. That when we hold on to God's baptismal pledge, that when we remember in grace that he paid the ultimate price to set us free from the chains of sin and death, that we become in God's eyes as clean and pure and beautiful as a brand new baby. While we in our heads have all this baggage and it weighs us down and sometimes holds us back, God declares that with him our sins are regularly crucified on the cross. I have been crucified with Christ, it says. Our pains and problems are absorbed by him, and we are reborn as children of God. Think about it. A whole history of God's people, look at the Old Testament, is the story really of scars and stains. Over and over again, we see stories of failure, of faithlessness, of foolishness, of fault. Even the great King David, look at our lesson today. A man, it says, after God's own heart, fails God miserably when he commits adultery with Bathsheba, and in covering it up, ends up causing the death of her husband. He lives with this buried inside until finally God sends the prophet Nathan to say to him, you are the man. And then David, then he lets it go and asks for forgiveness. And God's incredible response to our consistent failure is to consistently renew and refresh and rejuvenate. King David says to God, create in me a clean heart, renew a right spirit within me, cast me not away from your presence, take not your Holy Spirit from me. And God, for the sake of the coming Savior, says, yes, David, yes, I am so glad that you are free again from that sin which plagued you. Similarly, in our gospel, a sinful woman comes to Jesus and with a repentant heart anoints his feet with her tears. Doesn't Jesus know what kind of woman this is? Says the Pharisee. And Jesus declares very emphatically that he does. And then he is happy to say, your sins are forgiven. And the weight is lifted off her shoulders. This is his constant word to us, brothers and sisters. He says to you and me, whatever baggage you have, whatever faults and failures bring guilt, all the dirt and all the grime that has affected you, whether it be your own or that which has been done to you, when you are connected to me, know that I stand ready through the cross to make you new, to cleanse your memories, to renew your hearts, and to give you a fresh new start. That's what the sacraments are for us, my friends. God's way of not just saying it to us, but touching us personally, individually, to help us survive in this difficult and painful world. As we remember our baptisms, he energizes us to say to the tempter again and again as he taunts us and tests us, be gone. I don't need to listen to your deceptions. I'm a child of God. I'm a child of God. He has made me his own, and nothing, not anything you bring up, can separate me from his love. And when we step forward to receive the body and blood of Jesus at this altar, he stands before us and says, I know where you've come from. I know who you've been. I know the pain and the frustration and the loss. I know it all because I've walked in your shoes myself. I gave it all up for you. So take and eat my true body as a pledge and token that your sins are forgiven. Take and drink. This is my blood of the covenant shed for you. This means every day I stand beside you, having experienced your struggle, and offer you my eternal victory. And so today, take a look at Pippa. In reality, she kind of represents your everyday renewal in Christ. Her new life at this font should remind you every day of your fresh slate that comes each moment as you cling to Jesus Christ. Will you pray with me? Create in us clean hearts, O God, and renew the right spirit within us. Cast us not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Restore unto us the joy of your salvation, and uphold us with your free spirit. Create in us a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within us. For we have been crucified with Christ, and we live, yet not us, but Christ lives in us. And the life we now live, we live by faith in him, who gave himself for us. In Jesus' name we pray.